stick around, Jack, because as host of the Brit Awards, you'll know our next guest very well. He's won two Brits, sold 5 million albums, amassed 6 billion streams online, and he sounds like this.
Let's welcome to the studio, James Bay.
Yeah! See you, man.
It's so good to see you. We are really looking forward to hearing your new single. But listen, first, you've been keeping yourself busy during lockdown, giving out free guitar lessons.
And yeah.
That's kind of how your music career started, is it not?
It's one of the things I did at the sort of very beginning of... At a time when I'd finished school and I wasn't doing anything else yet, I was 18 and I did... There's me now.
Yeah.
I didn't know what I was sort of, how I was going to move into music in any way. I had about a year of time before I went and did like any sort of further education stuff, and I just taught guitar for a year. And I wasn't brilliant. I wasn't awful at it, though. So I kind of held on to it, and I, at the start of lockdown, I'm not a big user of social media, but I thought, well, what can I give? Everybody's kind of sat at home, a lot of people are. So I tried it there and then. I sort of thought, well, I'll show them what I do when I play my songs. And it's sort of carried on from there.
There are so many people who had that impulse during lockdown, didn't they, of trying to help out, thinking, what can I do to give something back? Well, someone who could have used your guitar lessons and a bit of your coaching is our man Jack here, because the thing is, Jack, some people didn't know this, and I've only just discovered it, but you very nearly had a role in the movie Bohemian Rhapsody.
Oh, wow.
Amazingly close to getting the part, except there was one significant problem.
Well, I think I was actually quite far away from getting the part from the outset, but my agent did lie to the casting director and told them that I could play the guitar. And I went along with that lie for a little bit and then had this awful moment where I realised that this was going to end in me being handed a guitar in an audition and having to pretend to play the guitar, at which point I gracefully bowed out.
I should say it was Brian May that you were auditioning to be, right?
Yeah, and it went to a guy, Gillian Lee, who's brilliant and actually can play the guitar. So
did you start growing your hair out at any point? To play
I was going to go to full James Bay and then permit
and then
for
permit.
The rock.
Yes.
That's amazing. Well, Queen have actually featured very heavily on the One Show playlist, which we're still adding to and which you can listen to by heading to BBC Sounds.
It started out as something to boost our mood in lockdown, but with no festivals or concerts, we've been turning it into our very own soundtrack of the summer. James, what would you add to it? If you could choose one song to add to the One Show playlist, what would it be?
I suppose it's got to be something that gets people up and moving. I like the idea of Once in a Lifetime.
Hey, Talking Heads.
Love it.
Talking Heads. I had Talking Heads my first song at my wedding.
There you go.
The one that's supposed to be the place. Okay. Kim, and you've added, I know the one you've chosen. This is an absolute banger. Why have you chosen this?
It is. Why would I not choose
huge
this?
Tune.
The real thing, it just makes me happy.
Yes.
It's like, you know, one of those songs you put on when you're getting ready to go out.
Yes.
It's just brilliant. Jack, you have possibly got the strangest suggestion so far.
I don't know what this is. What is it?
I kind of regret my decision, because now I'm talking to you, I've realised that 100% I should have put in Pure and Simple by Hearsay, which is... But I think I told the researcher that I wanted Ski Sunday theme tune.
Oh!
listen to that!
It is feel good after all.
That's like Sunday nights as a kid, right?
Yeah,
Sunday
Perhaps
nights.
We could still add Pure and Simple.
Yeah, we could. Let's have someone add Pure and Simple right now to the list. Let's move on quickly. James, you've got a new single and an album coming out, and you are typically, and we had a wonderful chat before we came on air about these issues and others. You're quite a private person, but this is a very personal album, and a lot of it is about your girlfriend.
Yeah, I found out. I wrote all these songs. I started writing these songs in sort of early in 2019. I did all sorts of fun stuff in 2019. I went on tour with Ed Sheeran, playing stadiums around
Europe.
Sounds
quite fun, yeah.
That was quite a high, pretty wild. And I carried on writing right up until going to Nashville to make the record in March. When I got home, lockdown began, and I had a moment with this music to just kind of reflect on it and listen to it. And it was only then that I realised that the boundary I'd pushed was lyrics. I'd sort of, I, instead of drawing from, I've drawn from a lot of kind of more negative emotions and sort of heartbreak type stuff in the past, I go to that place quite easily when I write. I realised I'd written all these songs because I've been with my girlfriend for 13 years and she's the absolute rock in my sort of roller coaster, the roller coaster moments of my life. She's always been there and always sort of pulled me through. And I realised I wanted to sort of show that gratitude, and it came out in these songs, which is of course quite a public place for me.
What's her name, mate?
Her name's Lucy. And it came out through the songs, and it's become this kind of tribute to all the time we've had together, and you know, all the time we'll have together.
That's the loveliest thing I think I've heard. I might cry.
That's
actually
definitely the highlight of my week. I tell you what,
it's
going to change what I say to my wife this evening accordingly, I think.
But listen, as you've said, you've toured with some amazing people.
Yes.
The Rolling Stones.
Yes.
Taylor Swift, Ed Sheeran, you mentioned.
Right.
And you've got a bit of a story about one of my heroes, Noel Gallagher.
Yeah, there's a wonderful Radio 2 breakfast show that I'd done a couple of times previous, and I was invited to do it again last summer. I flew back from that Ed Sheeran tour to do it. The usual format is there's the presenter, there's five or six celebrity guests, and there's the artist who'll do a new song and a cover. And I need to get my covers prepared. I need to sort of get them ready. So I take a lot of time and, you know, I'm practicing them right up until the last minute. And it was the lovely Fern Cotton was the presenter of the show, and she messaged me like the night before and she said, it's going to be nice to have you. I think she said she hadn't met Noel before, but she told me that Noel Gallagher was being on the thing, was going to be on the show. And I was like, that raises a problem. I didn't tell her. I tried to sort of fix it, but this was like the 11th hour the night before. So I went on the show and I said, okay, I found out when I got there that morning, it was like 7 a.m, the format had changed. It's now just the presenter, one guest, and the artist, and the guest was Noel. So I said
on
the
air...
And
what song were you doing?
Well, I said on the air, look, I've got a song of yours, Noel, and I don't know if I can do it in front of you, so maybe... I said, maybe I'll do... I've got, like, a backup Carol King song. He said, what's the Carol King song? I said, it's, Will You Still Love Me? He stopped me. He said, no, do my song. What are you talking about?
And you did Don't Look Back in Anger,
did you? Don't Look Back in Anger.
And it was absolutely wonderful. And we're going to watch you do a live performance in a second, which is not Don't Look Back in Anger, but it's your one. And you've no idea of the precautions we've had to take to ensure it's all safe, but we are incredibly excited about that, mate. Can't wait for it.
Well, first, with Holiday Parks reopening.